गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 11, ड्यूअल नेचर ऑफ रेडिएशन एंड मैटर। दिस इज द न्यू चैप्टर एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट, राइट। नाउ बिफोर गोइंग टू द फोटोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट, वी शुड नो द पार्टिकल थ्योरी ऑफ लाइट। मैक्स प्लैंक डेवलप द पार्टिकल थ्योरी ऑफ लाइट in which light energy is supposed to be propagating in the form of packets or particles. These energy particles are known as photon. Now, the packet or bundle of energy is called photon. Means whenever the source is emitting the light, it is emitting the light energy in the form of energy packets. These energy packets are known as photon, and the energy of that photon, of any photon, is equal to h nu or hc by lambda. As you know that nu is equal to c by lambda, means the speed of light is the product of frequency and wavelength. The energy of photon may be written as h nu or hc by lambda. It means the energy of photon depends on the frequency and the wavelength of light, right? So, in visual spectrum, red have highest wavelength. It means that has the lowest energy packets or energy photon, whereas violet has lower wavelength. It means higher frequency. So, the energy packet of violet will be have the higher energy, right? Now we are discussing about the properties of photon. A photon travels at the speed of light, that is c, in the vacuum, 3 × 10⁻⁸ meter per second. Since a photon is an energy packet of light, so it will travel in the form of in the speed of light. Second, the rest mass of the photon is zero, but photon cannot exist at the rest. It means if a photon becomes at the rest, so its mass will be zero, but it does not in the rest exist in the rest. It means every photon have mass, but that mass is very light. It means mass is very small. Kinetic energy of the photon is m is equal to e divided by c square or h divided by c nu. So this is the kinetic mass. Since energy of photon is very small, it is in the order of 10⁻⁹ joule. Its unit is electron volt. When we convert it into joules, so it comes out in the order of 10⁻⁹. And we are dividing this by c square. So the order of the mass will be 10⁻³⁵ kg. It means very small mass the photon have. So we can neglect the mass of the photon, right? Now the momentum of the photon, since there is a mass, there is a speed, then there should be a momentum. The momentum of the photon may be calculated with the formula P equal to E by C. Now E is very small. When we divide it by speed of light, so it comes out the smaller value. So the photon's momentum is very small. Photon always travels in the straight line. Is the property of light, right? Now energy of photon depends on frequency. Energy of photon depends on frequency. So the energy of photon does not change when photon travels from one medium to another. If a photon is traveling from one medium denser to rarer or rarer to denser, so its frequency never changes, since the energy of photon does not change, right? Next, the wavelength of the photon changes in different media. whenever the light is traveling from rarer to denser or denser to rarer, its wavelength changes and hence the speed also changes, velocity also changes. So whenever the light traveling from one medium to another, the wavelength and speed changes but frequency remains constant. Next, photon is electrically neutral. Since there is no charged particle, so photons are always electrically neutral. Photons may be diffraction, may show diffraction under given condition. So photon also exhibit the diffraction. Photons are not deviated by electric and magnetic. Now see, the charged particle always deviated in electric and magnetic field. But a photon do not have charge, it is electrically neutral. So it cannot be deviated in the electric and magnetic fields, right? Next is photoelectric effect. This is the main topic of our today's topic. Now see, whenever the light falls on the metal surface, the metal starts emitting electrons, but the frequency of the photon should be more than the sufficient energy or sufficient frequency. Whenever the light or photon incident at the metallic surface whose frequency is greater than the certain frequency, then it will start emitting the photoelectrons. This phenomena is called photoelectric effect. Now see, in the second case, this is the block of metal other than alkali metals. It is different from alkali metals. The visible light is incident at the metal surface, but it is not emitting the photoelectrons. In the second case, there is an alkali metal and a visible light incident at the surface, so it starts emitting the electrons. Reason is that alkali metal have lower work function, and the metals which are other than alkali metals have the work function greater than the alkali metals. So the photoelectrons comes out from the alkali metals, right? It means alkali metals are photosensitive material. Now we are going for the definition. Phenomena of emission of electron from metal surface exposed to the light of suitable frequency. Suitable frequency means it should be greater than the critical frequency. So it is known as photoelectric effect. The electron emitted from the metal surface are called photoelectrons. The electrons which are emitting from the metal surface, these are known as photoelectrons. The current constituted by photoelectrons is called photoelectric current. Whenever the electrons are moving, it means charge is moving, and moving charge per unit time is electric current, but that is due to the light effect, so it is called photoelectric current. Thik? Now this is the very important point. Non-metal also show the photoelectric effect. Non-metals also perform the photoelectric effect. But the photoelectric effect in metals is higher quality of effect in comparison of non-metals. Even though liquids and gases are also show this effect, but up to limited extent, right? Not always special liquids or gases can emit electrons when light energy incident on this liquid or gases, right? So this is the photoelectric effect. Now this is the Hallway's experiment. This was the first experiment performed in the photoelectric effect. Hallway's setup is that there is a quartz bulb which is evacuated, means the vacuum is created inside this glass bulb, quartz bulb. Two electrodes are fitted and these electrodes are connected with the battery. And there is a galvanometer to detect the current whether in circuit or not, right? So always perform this experiment with different wavelength lights, right? When the light falls on, whenever the absence of, in the absence of this light, there was no deflection in the galvanometer. But when the red color light incident at the electrode, there was also no current. But after repeating this experiment with Vibgior, ultimately he incident the ultraviolet region light on this electrode, so deflection occurs in the galvanometer. It shows that there is a current in the circuit. But for the current, there should be the movement of the charges. So when the ultraviolet light incident at this metallic electrode, it starts emitting electrons and reaches at the other electrode. So this completes the cycle of flow of electron. This experiment proves that there is a photoelectric effect, right? Now see this video. In this video, there is a structure. This is the tube, glass tube, having a window, and it is connected with the battery. When the light get incident at emitter electrons, the light emitted, the light incident at the electrode or metallic plate, there is the emission of photoelectrons from this metal surface. So it was completely absorbed by the plate and emit out the electrons. This process continues. Whenever the photon incident at the electrode, the electrons are emitted from this metallic surface. This was the Hallway's experiment, and reaches at the other electrode, so circuit becomes complete, and if circuit becomes complete, it means there will be the photoelectric current, right? This is the experiment performed by the Hallway's, and this was the famous experiment performed by the Hallway's. So there was the production of photoelectric current in the circuit due to movement of the electrons, right? So this is all about the photoelectric effect. Thank you very much.